When I took a little break from making videos, I would still get a ton of comments. But one day I was minding my own business and this one comment came in. I wasn't even gonna reply to it, but I didn't want people to believe that it was true. The reports of my death were greatly exaggerated. Intro. Yo, what up? My name is Vladimir Riché from chaseandrider.com. In this video, we're going to talk about the most versatile shirt. But before I get to that, man, it's been almost 2 years since I last released a long form video. Although I've been back on YouTube since late December making short form content. But I still get comments now, people welcoming me back. So I think a lot of people are not seeing my videos on their feeds because it's just YouTube shorts. But this is my first long form video and let's get it. So as I was saying, today's video is going to be about the most versatile shirt, which is the Oxford cloth button-down collar, affectionately known as the OCBD. Now, what makes the OCBD so versatile is the fact that you can pretty much wear it with anything. You can wear it with a suit, albeit a casual suit. I wouldn't wear it with a double-breasted suit, which is more of a formal suit. You can wear it with a sport coat. You can wear it without a coat. You can just wear it with trousers, whether it's jeans, out trousers, chinos, whatever you like. You can wear it tucked. You can wear it untucked. It's really the most versatile shirt that you can wear. Now, ironically, I'm not wearing that shirt today, although I've worn it in plenty of my videos. But long story short, the OCBD was actually originated right here in America. Rumor has it, the founder of Brooks Brothers, I think he was the founder, I don't know. He went to England and was catching a rugby game. And then he noticed that the rugby players had their collars buttoned to their shirt. That way it wouldn't flap on their face when they were running. So the idea came to him, he should make a shirt like that. And that's how the shirt was created. Many companies now make OCBD shirts. But make no mistake about it, Brooks Brothers were the first to do it. The first OCBD was released in the year 1900. So that goes to show you how long the OCBD has been around. So the first part of the name, Oxford cloth, is a type of cotton. But it's a very durable cotton. So that's the reason why OCBD shirts typically last a long time, because of the material is very tough. Now, even though Oxford cloth is supposed to be durable, it's also soft at the same time. So you don't feel like you're restricted, like you're wearing a Teflon shirt or something like that. You know what I mean? Now, the second part of the name, the button-down collar, is really what the OCBDs are known for. The collar is buttoned to the shirt, and that's what creates that nice collar roll. So if the shirt doesn't really have a nice collar roll, it's really not an OCBD, because the name of the game with the OCBD is the collar roll. There are a lot of companies that try to replicate the Brooks Brothers collar, and not all of them has been successful at doing that. But there are a few brands out there that do make really nice OCBD shirts outside of Brooks Brothers that do have really nice collars. Now, even though I don't know any stylish men that don't own at least 2 or 3 OCBDs, it is an acquired taste. Even for myself, when I first started getting into menswear, I didn't own any OCBD shirts because I only wore suits. It wasn't until later on I started wearing sport coats, and I felt weird wearing like this type of shirt that I'm wearing right now with a sport coat, you know, especially if I'm going tieless, right? That's when I started to look at what else was available, and then I discovered the OCBD, and I haven't looked back since. Like, I have so many other shirts. The OCBD is definitely a staple in every man's wardrobe, and like I was saying, the OCBD is so versatile. You can dress it up, you can dress it down, you can wear with denim, you can wear with chinos, you can wear with sport coats, without trousers, like I was saying before, you can wear with a suit. So it's definitely a staple that every man should have in their wardrobe. Although recently I got a comment with some guy telling me that I should throw out all my OCBDs. I don't know where that guy is from. Because even though the OCBD started in America, they are worldwide. You have companies like Kamakura shirts out of Japan that make a really, really nice OCBD. A lot of my Italian friends love OCBDs, so I don't know what the hell that guy was talking about. So even though I'm not wearing an OCBD shirt today, I do have one handy that I want to talk to you guys about. It's a very special one. And this one is from Vekla. Vekla, if you're not aware, is the same company that makes Sons of Henry shoes. As you guys know, I'm a big proponent of Sons of Henry shoes. It was the first brand to send me a free pair of shoes for me to unbox for you guys on the channel. But it's not only because of that, they make a great product. And that's no different with their shirts. And just to be completely transparent, even though this video is not sponsored by Vekla, they did send me a couple shirts for me to review and then tell you guys about it. So no money has changed hands. So right now, with you guys watching the video for the first time, that's also their first time watching the video. So everything that you're hearing right now, those are my thoughts only. So a couple details about the Vekla OCBD. Number one, the cotton is sourced from America and it's an organic cotton. So if you care about the environment, that's a pretty cool detail. Number two, the shirts are pre-washed and pre-shrunk, which means that you don't have to worry about them shrinking on you after you watch it for the first time. I had that happen with one of my OCBDs from another brand. When I got it, the sleeves were a little bit too long, so I took it to my tailor to shorten the sleeves a little bit. And then I wore the shirt, they fit perfectly. Then I got them dry cleaned, and after that, I haven't been able to wear them again because now the sleeves are too short. Another detail with their shirts, they actually have four different colors. They have the light blue, they have a white, they have a navy, and they also have one that's white and blue stripes. One feature that they have is they match the pattern. So in the back, where the collar is connected to the back, and then where the sleeves are connected to the body of the shirt, the patterns match. And that's something that you will notice on their white and blue stripes. As I was saying, the fabric is sourced in America, but the shirts are actually made in Portugal. Another great feature is the mother of pearl buttons that you get on the shirts. Now, if you're not familiar with mother of pearl buttons, also called MOPs, not only are these buttons very tough, but they also look better because they have kind of like a different shape to them, especially when the light hits them. I don't know if you can kind of see it on here, but you can clearly see these aren't your typical plastic buttons. Also, to get that perfect collar roll that I was talking about, not only is the collar oversized, but it's also unlined, meaning that there's no material inside of the collar. That means you're going to get an excellent roll from the Vekla OCBD collars. These shirts are really, really cool. And one thing that I like about them is that they all come in a contemporary fit. So you're not really going to get a slim fit, but it's also not overly baggy. So it's like right in between baggy and slim. Because once again, these shirts are really made to be worn casually. So you really don't want something like that to be slim fit, you know what I mean? At least I don't. So typically with shirts, it's really the shirt collar. So it's like me, I'm like a 16, 16 and a half, 34, 35 arms. Vekla shirts aren't measured like that. They come in five different sizes. Extra small, small, a medium, a large, and an extra large. But if you go on their website, you can see what neck size and what sleeve length corresponds with the different sizing. Now you're probably wondering how much these shirts are. As I was saying, Brooks Brothers are the one that started making these shirts, and the Brooks Brothers shirts retail for around $98. So the Vekla shirts, not including VAT, are $58, which is an excellent price for what you're getting. And for $58 to get a shirt that's made out of organic cotton, that's pre-shrunk and pre-washed with mother of pearl buttons, that's a really, really good deal in my opinion. I will include the link to the shirts in the description. Also, if you use the code VLAD, V-L-A-D, you get an extra 5% off. Once again, use the code VLAD, V-L-A-D, to get an extra 5% off. So let me know in the comments how you feel about OCBDs. Do you already own a couple, or something that you're willing to try, or you don't like them? Whatever the case may be, I'm looking forward to hearing your thoughts in the comments. Another thing before I forget, on the regular Brooks Brothers shirt, they do have a front pocket, but as you can see with the Vekla one, there's no front pocket on there, which personally I kind of like, because it's not like I'm going to be using the front pocket anyway. But yeah, I think this is a really great shirt for the price, man, and I'm really looking forward to what you guys have to say about them in the comments. And if you're wondering what I'm wearing on my feet, since you can't see it, I don't know if the watch strap gives it away since it's burgundy, which means that I'm wearing burgundy shoes. So today I'm wearing my Adelaides from Enzo Bonafé with the pig heel counter. It's one of my favorite shoes, fit me like a glove. And like I was saying, I've been dropping a ton of videos since late December. So if this is your first time seeing me back, please go check out all the YouTube shows that I've put out. There should be about 50 of them, probably even more than that. I did do a series called 30 Tips in 30 Days. So for 30 straight days, I released a video. And prior to that, I think I released about 15. Something like that. Anyway, check out all the videos that I put out since late December of 2022. But every week, man, I'm going to release a long form video, so be on the lookout for those as well. So hit the thumbs up if you like this video, subscribe, everybody gonna think that you're a hater, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace. I've been dying to say that for a minute, man. Man, that feels good.